Hello everyone, welcome back in biology class. Students, as you are knowing, we are studying the chapter Why Do We Fall Ill in Biology. Until now, you studied up to the non-infectious diseases. Today, I am going to explain a new topic. In the same chapter, that will help you to understand about the diseases, and the topic is how communicable diseases transmitted from an infected person to a healthy person. Let's begin it. Watch the video carefully. Dear students, the date is 9/10/2020. Subject: biology. And class is 9, and name of chapter we are studying is Why Do We Fall Ill. And in this chapter, we are going to study about transmission of communicable diseases. This is our today's. Students, here you have to know that only communicable diseases, because they transmitted from an infected person to a healthy person, that's why they are called the communicable diseases. And these communicable diseases are transmitted from infected person to a healthy person by different means. And this means we broadly study under two points. That is, one mode of transmission is direct transmission. Direct transmission. Okay? Direct transmission, in which the person which is suffering from a communicable disease is come in direct contact with the person who is healthy. Okay? How many types of contacts are there? You can take one direct contact, that is the physical contact. Physical contact. Which type of contact is called physical contact? Just like shaking hands, hug, this type of contact are direct contact. And diseases like chicken pox. This type of disease is chicken pox. Viral disease. Chicken pox. Smallpox. Ringworm. These are examples of some diseases which are transmitted from an infected person to a healthy person being in direct physical contact. Okay. So if a person is suffering from ringworm or suffering from chickenpox or smallpox, if you come in contact by shaking hands, hugging, or by any other social means, okay, So such there is a risk of spreading of such type of disease in healthy person. Okay. So this is physical contact. Now the another type of contact is sexual contact. Sexual contact. Diseases like syphilis, gonorrhea, AIDS, herpes, these are some kind of diseases. AIDS means acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. That is the AIDS. Okay. So this type of diseases like syphilis and gonorrhea are the bacterial diseases. AIDS, herpes are the viral diseases. And they are transmitted, these diseases are transmitted from infected person to a healthy person by being in sexual contact. Students, AIDS is a very deadly disease. In previous day perhaps we studied, AIDS is caused by human immunovirus. Okay, and that's why it is short form is HIV AIDS. Okay, so this disease is called syndrome, not a disease, because it has the symptoms of many diseases, mixed symptoms of many diseases. Okay, so this is AIDS. Besides this, AIDS can also spread by the blood transfusion. Means if a person suffering from AIDS donate the blood to a healthy person, that is the blood transfusion. Use of used syringes, means syringe that used to inject some kind of medicines in the body. If it has been injected earlier to an infected person and same injection has been used for a healthy person, then that disease will spread. Okay, so this is the means. These are some examples of the diseases which spread from a healthy person to a infected person to a healthy person by being in sexual contact. Besides this, the other are also like next is by being in contact of soil. Contact with soil. Students, when we come in direct contact with the soil, some microorganisms, disease causing microorganisms, enter in our body through the injury, any injury that is occur on the surface of the body, and they cause infections in the body. You can take here the example of tetanus. Tetanus is an example of the disease in which whenever, perhaps you heard also, that whenever we hurt or injured by any rusted iron piece or glass, the person or parents, guardians or knowledgeable people advise us to take the TT injection, tetanus injection, because they know this thing that by being in contact with the soil, the tetanus causing microorganism enter in the body through the injury. Okay, now so this tetanus is a disease that spread through come in contact with the soil and it is a mode of direct contact. Okay, now another type of disease is in the mode is animal's bite. Animal's bite, like sometimes dog, monkey, jackal, this type of animals often bite the human beings. You can take the example of diseases rabies. Okay, so the animal when bites a healthy person, it comes in direct contact. Okay, so it is a mode of direct transmission in which the disease like rabies is spread from animals to humans, other animals to human beings, is animal bite. Some animals who are rabid, means already infected by the rabies virus, they entered in the body of a healthy human through the saliva of the animal who bite that person. Okay, so this is the direct transmission of communicable diseases. Now we will study how communicable diseases transmitted to an infected person to a healthy person by being in indirect contact. Okay, so by transmission of communicable disease by indirect transmission, without being in contact, in direct transmission. In this, the infected person and healthy person are not in direct contact. You can take the example of by ear. Here the ear become medium for the transmission. Okay, many diseases like TB. Okay, this spread by being in indirect contact. Suppose an area where is the too much crowd, and any person infected with the TB that came there and sneeze. So in sneezing, the droplets contain the bacteria and it spread in that crowded hall. Those who are in close contact, they will more likely to be infected by this type of disease. Okay, so air provide a medium. The disease causing microorganisms float and cover a long distance with the help of air. Okay, some scientists are saying that there are sufficient evidence to prove that corona also spread through it. But it is more research will going on, then we will become confirmed. Okay, so this indirect transmission by air, by food and water. Food and water also help in the spreading of disease. By food you can take the example of cholera. By water you can take the example of typhoid. Okay, many are there. So these are the diseases that are spread by being in indirect contact. When we eat or drink the infected polluted food or water, these diseases spread, enter in our body through this food or water. That's why it is often advisable that don't use the food that is open on the road. okay, don't use the already cut piece of fruit, okay, because they maybe had the some kind of microorganism that can cause disease and they receive through the air, and now if the person will eat that infected polluted food item, the microorganism get the chance to enter in the body where it use the mechanism of body, reproduce, increase number and cause problem for the human beings. Similarly, the typhoid is also spread through the water and the microorganism generally is transmitted through the feces. Feces are mixed in the water and through which it spread in the human beings. Okay, so this is the one mode method. Many diseases are there. I am talking about the method here, not about the diseases. So I am giving various examples. Okay, by food and water. Cholera and typhoid. Here, by vectors, do you know? Vectors are the carriers of pathogens, means disease causing microorganisms. Pathogen means disease causing microorganisms. Causing microorganisms are called pathogens. Vectors, you can take the example of vectors like mosquito. Mosquitoes are the vectors of many diseases. Perhaps you remember that malaria, dengue, this type of diseases are spread through dengue. Sometimes it is called dengue also. So this type of disease is spread through the vectors. Vector will have the microorganisms, disease causing microorganisms of dengue and malaria. Different types of mosquitoes are there. And they when bite the healthy person, the microorganisms enter into the body of healthy person, and where it cause infection and person will start suffering from the malaria or dengue. Domestic fly. Means bee. It is also responsible for many diseases like cholera, hazel. They sit on the dirty polluted things and again fly from there and come on and sit on the open food items where they leave the microorganisms which are attached to the body of fly, and that later on that food has been used by healthy person and microorganism got the chance to enter in the body of human's body, and there it caused infection. Okay, so domestic fly is an vector. Now another type of transmission is the fomite bug. D. This will be the D. Fomite bug means used articles. This means if a person which is healthy and use the articles which are already used by an infected person, then there is a chance of spread of that disease into the healthy person. Burning example you can take is the Corona. It is advisable that don't use the handles or unnecessary things by bare hand. And if you are forced to use, then sanitize your hands or the articles before and after touch. Okay? So these are some modes of indirect transmission by air, by food and water, by vectors and by fomite bond. Okay? And indirect transmission, the physical contact, sexual contact, contact with soil and animals by terrier. Okay? So you have to study all these modes of transmission and with example, with their example, at least one example you should have of each kind of disease. And if you learn that which kind of disease is that, whether it is bacterial disease, viral disease, protozoan disease, what type, fungal disease, okay, viral disease, whatever. So it will be much better for you. Okay. Thank you very much. This is all for today. Watch the video carefully again and again, and perhaps we are soon thinking about some direct contact program with the students. Okay? Have a nice day.